Happy St. Patrick's Day, Penguins. It's Tuesday. It is St. Patrick's Day. I wanted to connect with you about yesterday's book that we read out loud. It was called Penguin Problems. And I asked if some of you would consider making your own penguin at home. And I made a penguin today. And it's terrible art. Get it? Because it's terrible. Not that it's terrible, but it's I tore it. I didn't use scissors on it. And it was kind of fun. It was something to do. And so I'm going to save this, and I'm hoping that you, if you are a walker and you're here playing outside, or you're on a walk with your pets and you want to drop yours off, you're going to see a mailbox that Mrs. Burton's going to show you in a little bit that you can put your penguin in. Put your name on the back, and I'll take them each day and put them on the windows so you can keep working on your penguin. Today is St. Patrick's Day, and you notice that everybody wears green on St. Patrick's Day. So I pulled a couple of books in the library, and I thought I would share them with you today. The first is called Days to Celebrate, so it has all sorts of holidays in it. And I looked in the index, which is in the back, to find the page that the March 17th of St. Patrick's Day was explained. So I thought some of you might want to know, who is St. Patrick, and what's he doing? And why does Mrs. Swan have that goofy green hat on her head? So here we go. It says, Patrick was the patron saint of Ireland, but he was not Irish. That's interesting. He was born about 385 AD. 385. Yikes. Somewhere in Western England, so not in Ireland. St. Patrick's Day commemorates his death on March 17th. So that's the day he died. The year is uncertain, and it, estimates range from 461 to 464 AD, so they just know the date that he died. The first St. Patrick's Day celebration in the United States was held in Boston, Massachusetts in 1737. For centuries, the shamrock, which is this small green three-leafed plant resembling clover, has been an emblem of Ireland. Folklore tells us that when St. Patrick drove the snakes out of Ireland, he stood in a shamrock patch. Part of an old Irish song gives St. Patrick credit for bringing the plant to Ireland. And this must be this song. There's a dear little plant that grows in our isle, 'twas St. Patrick himself sure that said it. And the sun on his labor with pleasure did smile, and with dew from his eye oft-times wet it. It grows through the bog, through the brake, through the mireland, and he called it the dear little shamrock of Ireland. So that's just interesting. Gives you a little reason of why we're wearing green. And the Boston Celtics, if you're a basketball fan, now you know why they're called the Celtics, and they have green and white in theirs. I have to thank Jet and Jet's family for bringing this book back. Jet had this checked out, and he brought it back so that I could read it to you. This is a fiction novel, and it's called The Gingerbread Man and the Leprechaun is Loose at School. And I know a lot of you, Mrs. Lineski told me a lot of you have read this or have heard it and really liked it. So I'm excited to read it too.
Ooh, Mrs. Swan, what? Another thing kids could do today is make a leprechaun trap.
Yeah, that would be fun. Cool. You could take a picture of it with your mom or dad's cell phone and maybe send it to your teacher. That would be fun. One Monday in March, the mischief began with a hee-hee-hee from a wee little man. Oh boy, look at We heard the sly laugh as he raced down the hall, then he paused by our door with a wink and a call. Fall fiddly-fee, you can't catch me, for I'm on a leprechaun mess-making spree. Those leprechauns are tricky. I'm crafty and keen, I'm nimble and quick, I love to make mischief or play a good trick. I don't know how excited those kids are about that. We rushed to the hall. He was nowhere in sight. It seems that our school has an We rushed to the hall. He was nowhere in sight, but some tiny green shamrocks trailed off to the right. It seems that our school has an unwanted guest, a magical, mischievous leprechaun pest. We quietly tiptoed our way down the hall, then spied a small message taped up on the wall. The woodwinds, the strings, percussion, and brass are turned topsy-turvy, awaiting your class. Music, I whispered. The band room's this way. But when we arrived, we all stared in dismay. The sheets were all scattered, the tubas were tipped, the trumpets, violas, and flutes were all flipped. And there on the board was another green note. I grabbed it and read out his rascally quote, "Fo fiddly fee, you can't catch me, for I'm as clever can be. The musical mess is just the first one. It's rollicking, frolicking leprechaun fun. Let's tidy this room and then plan what to do before he comes back and makes mess number two. After our lunchtime, we'll work on a trip. Someone must capture that small, cheeky chap." Oh, hang on, I gotta go back. "After our lunchtime, we'll work on a trap. Someone must capture that small, cheeky chap." Didn't make sense for a minute. I slipped from the lunch line and went for a stroll to prowl all the hallways on prankster patrol. I'll search through the school as fast as I can. I can catch him. I'm the gingerbread man. I spotted more shamrocks, then heard a new noise. I pushed on a door with a sign that said, "Boys." The place was a mess. Then I yelled with a blush, "Where are your manners? Remember to flush." Look, it's that green pea in there. I glanced in the mirror, then spied his green note. I quickly retrieved it and read what he wrote. "Fo fiddly fee, you can't catch me, for I'm as sneaky can be. I placed all the books in my favorite shape and planned a few hijinks before my escape. He's loose in the library. This is not good. He won't treat the books in the way that he should. I'm on the case," I said as I ran. "I can catch him. I'm the gingerbread man." The books were all stacked in a rainbow display. They teetered and tottered and started to sway. Down they all came in an avalanche slide. They toppled so fast I had no time to hide. Then under the pile I was startled to find something important that he'd left behind. Beside his green note was a little lost hat. I'm betting that he might be looking for that. I sprang from the books and I grabbed his hat too. Then I opened the message to read his next clue. "Fo fiddly fee, you can't catch me, for I'm as tricky can be. The lunchroom? A classroom? Which place should I go? Or how about a house made from gingerbread dough?" My classroom, my house, I must get there first. I sped down the hall in a super fast burst. I'm on a mission, I've got a good plan. I can catch him, I'm the gingerbread man. I reached our door quickly, no sign of the elf. So I gathered supplies from a low closet shelf. I grabbed all the pencils, a ruler and glue, then found toilet tissue and pulled it down too. Kind of hard to find some these days. I set up my trap, then I heard a small giggle. I peered out our door and I saw the knob jiggle. "Fo fiddly fee, ha ha hee hee, is that my magical hat that I see?" With a glint in his eye, he skipped through the door, not noticing glue that was spread on the floor. Slipping and sliding, his arms whirled around as a log rolled on pencils laid out on the ground. He landed on top of the measuring stick. The ruler popped up and it gave him a flick. So he was like, ooh. He slid down a mountain of soft tissue rolls, but his shoes were so sticky it stuck to his soles. Flipping and flopping, he spun round and round, then wrapped like a mummy, he rolled to the ground. The trap did the trick. I pulled off my plan. "Hello, leprechaun, I'm the gingerbread man. Fo fiddly fee, oh my, oh me, this is a bind that I didn't foresee. I'm happy to help you, but first you must say you'll fix up the messes you've left here today." "Okay, little cookie, so crafty and keen, just hand me my hat and I promise to clean." "That's quite a good trick, but I'm smarter than that. You must do it first, then I'll give you your hat." "Oh, you're pretty clever as me," he winked and then said, "May your school be mess-free." With a pop and a crackle of shimmering green, the mess disappeared and the classroom was clean. So I pulled on the tissue and spun him around, then he sprang to his hat with a leap and a bound. He sang out, "I'm free," as my classmates came in. Then he did a quick jig with a wave and a grin. It's time to be going. My mischief is done, but I'll visit next March with more leprechaun fun. I'm up for the challenge. We'll have a new plan. Bring it on, leprechaun. I'm the gingerbread man. That's the end. That's pretty good, huh? by Laura Murray and illustrated by Mike Lowry. So Laura Murray and Mike Lowry, thank you for the work that you do for kids. That's awesome. Okay, so I was thinking, if you could come up with, I don't know, do you have something to write with? I bet a lot of you have journals. A piece of paper. All the words that rhyme with the word green. So I'm thinking, I know one. Bean, like a green bean. B-E-A-N. How about clean? I can clean my room. I bet there's a lot more you can find. See if you can find three more. One, two, three more. See if you can find three more that rhyme. If you want, a grown-up can write those down for you, too, if you can just think of the words that rhyme that sound the same. This over here, this is a challenge. This is a big word, leprechaun. Look how it's spelled. It does not spell itself phonetically. C-H for the K sound. So L-E-P-R-E-C-H-A-U-N. I'm wondering if you can take letters and rearrange them and make new words. Maybe some three-letter words like N-A-P is nap. I wonder if you could make a four-letter word. P-E-A-R is a pear. And wow, could some of you find any five or six-letter words? How about chapel? C-H-A-P-E-L. Is that five? One, two, three, four. Oh, that's six. 6 points on that one. Mrs. Burton, you see any five-letter words?
Preach.
Oh,
P-R-E-A-C-H. Ooh, that's six,
ooh,
too. Ooh, I get 6 points.
Nice. Preach.
Woohoo.
I'm going to make this a six. Those are six-letter words. So see what you can find. That's kind of fun. Something to do today for St. Patrick's Day. And then we're going to show you where you can put, if you're a walker, where you can put the mailboxes, or put your penguins if you're a walker and can put them in the mailbox. Also, I wanted to tell you that we are disinfecting, spraying down the playground equipment on the playground. So just know that that's been clean. And if you're worried and you just need to make sure you're keeping a safe distance around everybody else that's around you if you're outside and playing, or you can wear gloves if you're going to be touching things. So we are going to sign off for now. I think we are almost through day two together and together remotely together. And if you can tell your moms and dads that we will be in touch with them soon about what the next steps are going to look like. Have a great night. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
So boys and girls, Mrs. Swan told you that she would have a mailbox out here in front of the school for you to drop off your penguins. And so we wanted to show you where that's at. Here's the front of the school, and there is a flower box over to the left of the front door. And if you walk around to the back of the planter box, kind of hidden in here amongst the flowers and shrubs, is a mailbox that you can stick your penguins in. And we're hoping that we get lots of penguins in there, and Mrs. Swan will start putting them up in the windows so you can see them when you come by.
Hey, the flag means there's one in there. So the flag needs to be down right now, but you put the flag up when you've put yours in. And then I know if I walk by and the flag's up, there's something in there for me. All right, fun.